Why?
It's mine, that's why.
Does she have a sister?
Yeah.
Yeah?
You like going out with 7-year-olds? Sure. Yeah, she's good.
Okay.
She caresses your back while you're doing it, you know?
Does she scratch?
Yeah.
Oh, God.
It's really nice.
Tell me, who came first?
They both did it at the same time. It always happens that way.
Good timing.
Well, it always happens that way, man.
Always?
Yeah.
How many times did you count?
About 3, 4, you know.
3, 4?
Yeah.
What about foreplay?
Well, we did that too, you know.
Well, what did you do? Wait, come on, foreplay. I mean, what did you do when you did that too? Tell me what.
What we were doing, playing with our toes, you know.
Playing with our toes?
Yeah, you do that while you're doing it, you know. It's really good, man.
You do it and play with your toes?
Yeah.
How do you reach?
No, I was playing with her toes, with my toes, you know.
What kind of girls like to do it, and what kind of girls don't?
You gotta check out the way they walk, you know.
The way they walk?
Yeah. See, Sandra walks, you know. I can't describe it. It's hard to describe, but...
Go ahead.
Well, no, I can, man. I mean, you know, you can't describe it. You just gotta see it, you know.
Well, like what? Like this?
Well, yeah, you can't describe it, you know what I mean? But Sandra, she's good, man. Oh, she's good.
I gotta take gym class. I'm gonna take a cold shower.
Okay, see you later.
Right.
Remember, don't forget about Sandra.
And Debbie.
Yeah, Sandra.
Debbie.
Oh, okay. I like to English.
Yeah. See you later.
We've now seen the skit on male locker room talk, and as we all know, this definitely does go on. Addressing this question to the males on our committee here, what does really go on?
Not that much, really. you don't ask if they pen or not, but nothing. No, really, nothing to that extent. That was so exaggerated; it was funny. But to an extent, that talking does go on, but nothing
yeah,
like that.
We
nothing.
Talk, but we don't talk to the detail that he went to. I mean, you know, does he scratch or, you know, does he pant? I mean, questions like that you don't ask. Yeah.
I agree it's come some kind of fetish there, you know.
A little kinky.
How did you react as a woman watching this?
I thought it was quite disgusting myself. Like, does she scratch? Like, how many times did you come? Like, that's pretty sick, you know. I think that's kind of a rude question to ask someone in the first place. Like, you know, it's nobody's business to ask that. And the guy who was telling about it, I thought he was shoveling it awfully well. Like, yeah. It didn't sound like any of it was true.
It makes me sick when, like, young teenagers, guys, start going out with girls and, you know, they're always saying, oh.
Thank you. young and responsible bachelor can be tough. Not because I'm living with my best friend, Bugs Crutchett, who's out of work, or because I live next door to a religious freak who accuses me of being a homosexual antichrist communist just because I don't attend church, but because of discovering realities and responsibilities.
Are you there? Why do you do it?
Do what?
Squeeze the toothpaste at the top and then roll at the bottom, for Christ's sakes.
Well, it's a childhood habit.
One more wasted toothpaste and you'll be brushing your gums. When are you gonna get a job?
I'm still looking.
At the moment, you seem to be stuffing your face with my groceries, bought and paid for by me. When am I gonna stop being the wife and husband you never had?
Well, I take the garbage out.
Oh, God, he takes the garbage out.
Do you think it's fun staying home day after day, putting up with that Mrs. McGillicuddy next door? God, that's a mean woman. She's always complaining about trimming the hedge. Like, it's on the property line, like you know? And people walking by think it's her hedge. Just last week, she was complaining about me missing prayer meeting. What are you, an atheist? And every second day, she's always over here wanting to borrow a cup of sugar.
Well, tell her to buy her own.
I don't want to get her on my bad side.
She doesn't have a good side to get on.
And her dogs are always over here. We got four different breeds of dog crap on our front lawn. Looks like a minefield.
Well, it'll give me something to do. Buy one of those super duper pooper scoopers and shovel it up. I can't. The dog crap was demolished yesterday. I was mowing the lawn. Is that why the living room window's so filthy? Yes. And we better do something about it. I was thinking of setting up a 20-man committee to drive out of the neighborhood.
It's not that bad.
Not that bad? The woman's impossible.
Bugs, cry on my shoulder when you get a real problem.
Right now, find a job or I'll pluck your eyebrows from the inside of your head. This is a real problem. This morning, I was carrying four bags of garbage down that narrow driveway. That's four bags. Four. Count them. One, two, three, four. On the way, I happened to step on some of Mrs. McGillicuddy's dog crap. I slid all the way down the driveway. And the bags broke, and there's garbage all over the place. They're top of garbage bags. I believe that commercial. I think she trains her dogs to do that.
You're paranoid.
I am not. Just that she hates me.
We've been out of school for a year. That's 1 year, counted one, yet you still don't have a job.
Well, who's counting? Three more days, it'll be exactly a year ago today that we graduated. June 15th, 1958.
Don't get technical. I know exactly where you can get a job. Good chance of getting one anyway.
Where?
Right where I work, John's Motors.
No way.
What do you mean, no way?
What does no way usually mean?
It means if you don't get a job, I'll take your tonsils out through your ears.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna brush my teeth and then I'm gonna hide the toothpaste. It's about time you started doing things for yourself.
You mean, you're not gonna fix me up with girls anymore?
I'll do that much. What are friends for?
It's just what I'm gonna do. Get dressed, go out, and get a job. Because I'm getting seasick of that Mrs. McGillicuddy and her trained dogs and her lack of sugar.
And also, I want this pig paradise cleaned up. I'll get a shovel and clean the mold off the walls.
Why me?
You messed it up, you can clean it up.
What's for supper tonight?
Roast.
Mrs. McGillicuddy.
Excuse me.
No, excuse me. I'm late for work. I got it.
Excuse me. I have to make a wedding cake for my daughter.
Oh,
she's getting married.
Oh, that's nice. Yeah. Well, I'm late. Excuse me. I have to be here.
I just happened to be out of sugar. I'd appreciate it very much if I would borrow a cup.
I never expected to run into one of my old school flames, who's like any other school flame. Even though she's a narrow-minded, uptight, and snobby bitch, because she was raised to be that way, but I say this with respect. What you gonna do anyway, I'll run dry. You gonna run away and hide. I'm gonna run right by your side. You pretty baby,
I even die. She had a sister?
I suppose you want me to fix you up again.
Oh, please, I really want to be with a girl. And I don't mean my Aunt Betsy. She's always sending my suicide telegrams.
Do you remember what happened the last time I fixed you up with a girl? Huh?
Please don't talk about that.
You got drunk and tried to take your pants off over your head.
Well, I've asked plenty of girls out by myself. Like Penny Rogers. Do you remember her? I asked her out.
Did she turn you down?
She turned me upside down. I lost $5 and quarters and dimes.
Well, it just so happens that she is bringing a girl over. In fact, she insisted on bringing her over. I said I wanted to see her alone, but then I thought of you. And I said to myself, now I know Bugs is anxious to meet a girl, so I agreed. I'm touched. I always thought so.
Honey made it clear as long as she brought Candide over, she'd drop by. And after all I've done for you, I think you owe me this, right? And besides, I already told her that I have a friend here.
Who?
You, stupid.
Well, I don't know about girls, Max. I don't know what to say or what to do or what not to do.
Bugs, didn't your father tell you about girls, the facts of life?
Yeah, my father told me about the facts of life, but I got nauseous and threw up on them. All that talk about female organs and male organs and the things they do, it's disgusting.
Well, that's the way it's done.
Swell. You can start.
It saddens me to think that Bugs' father...
Hi, Max. Nice to see you, dude.
Nice to see you, too.
You're crushing me.
It's completely my pleasure. Where's Honey?
She's parking the car.
Say, did Honey say anything to you about me?
Did Honey say anything about you? Not much. Just that she's looking forward to seeing you again.
She did. Oh, sorry. This is Bugs Crutchett.
Hi.
And this is lovely Candy Wilson.
Hi!
I mean, hi.
I've heard a lot about you, Bugs.
Oh, it's not true. Whatever they said.
No, thanks.
It's okay, I forgive you.
You forgive me?
You're cute when you're angry.
It's humiliating.
Yeah, I'm gonna be gorgeous in a minute.
I like to see that.
Why should I beg someone to go out with me? That's what I ended up doing with Honey. Why should I take her to a place I can't afford? Why should I agree with her to take Bugs with us? To act as a chaperone?
Yes, well, do you desire anything else? Oh, I don't know. Do you desire anything else, anybody?
Not really desire. It's more of a lust.
Well, what do you lust for?
Can we have some of that wine? Please, you promised.
I did? Oh, okay. We'll have some of that wine that tastes like mashed potatoes. If you don't have that, we'll have the best.
Oh, yes, sir. The best.
What a...
This is the last time I'm going out with you.
Now you did it. Don't forget about the tip.
I'll meet you back at your place where we'll discuss this.
We'll discuss it tomorrow.
We'll discuss it tonight.
You're turning purple, honey.
Like the potatoes.
I don't see anything funny here.
You do. I don't. We do.
We do.
Yeah, that's it. We do.
Max, I thought you were a gentleman.
Oh, come on, honey. Don't be such a stuffed shirt.
Let me rephrase that.
You don't have to.
You know what your problem is? I think something's missing from your life.
What's that?
Me.
Well, is that so? Well, I think there's something missing from your life.
What's that?
A lift home. I'm not catering you around anymore. You can walk home. Now I'm going to your place and I'm going to meet you there. And you better be a fast walker. Bye.
I'm in the mood for love simply because you're near me. Funny, but when you're near me, I'm in the mood for love. Good morning.
Morning.
Crunchle dog food.
What? I'm eating dog food?
Yeah. Miss McGillicuddy asked me to babysit her poodle.
What? I'm eating poodle food?
Yeah.
Oh, what a dirty trick.
I asked Honey if she would consider a relationship with me, but her silence answered my question. She was wondering what her parents would think. There she goes, inflicting self-denial. She's completely under her parents' control. She is weak, and she'll suffer for it later.